redox reactions in titrations. In which one here? The titrations. So what is the meaning of titration? Okay, so titration is nothing but, that is nothing but you can use the two solutions. In those two solutions, one solution's concentration is known. That is called as standard solution. What it is called as here? Standard solution. On using of the standard solution, you have to calculate the concentration of second solution. Concentration of here the second solution. So that is called as here the titration. Are you understand? In the titration, we can use the words. One is the standard solution. Okay, so another one is here the unknown solution. So standard solution is nothing but concentration known solution is called as standard solution. On using of the standard solution, you have to calculate the concentration of unknown solution. Okay, so this information is called as titration. What it is called as here? Titrations. Generally, titrations are used for acids and bases. Okay, generally the titration word is used for the calculation of the concentration of acids and bases. Okay, so now these titration also includes which one here? The redox reactions. Includes which one here? The redox reaction. For that one, I want to explain with one example. So already you know about the, what is the formula of potassium permanganate here? The KMnO4. Okay, so in the KMnO4, always manganate ion should be present, like MnO4-. It can be work as here the self indicator. Okay, what it is here? The self indicator. That means we should not add any color substance, any indicator. What is the meaning of indicator here? The simply where the reaction is completed. Okay, that should be denoted by here the indicator. Okay, so whenever the indicator is used, then only you have to calculate which one here the end point. For the calculation of the end point, you can use here the indicator. Okay, for the titration of the potassium permanganate, we should not use any indicator. Due to the reason, potassium permanganate can work as here the self indicator. Okay, so generally this compound should be taken in burette. Taken in burette. So I think in your SSC purpose or in your 9th class purpose, there should be the burette, pipette. Okay, these two instruments. And again, in your second year chemistry, these words also came. Why? Because there should be practical. In the practical, we can also use the potassium permanganate. Okay, but I am simply giving you the information about the potassium permanganate. Whenever it should be participates in the titration, okay, the end point is nothing but solution color changed into light pink color. Which color here? Light pink color. Okay, so then this light pink color means our manganate ion, which are here the our manganate ion completely oxidizes. Which one here? The completely oxidizes. So that means in the KMnO4, MnO4- ions are completely oxidized. Is known by whenever the color changed to colorless to light pink color. Okay, that means oxidizes means is nothing but the increasing of oxidation number. Okay, so that should be observed in the KMnO4. So KMnO4 work as a self indicator. Okay, it is suitable. If we are shooting the potassium dichromate, I am taking which one here? The potassium dichromate, K2CR2O7. It should not work as the self indicator. It should not work as self indicator. So for this oxidation, we can use here diphenylamine. Okay, what it is here? The diphenylamine substance. Which one? It should be work as the indicator. Okay, so after the total oxidization of chromium ions, that should be converting into here the blue color. Which color here? The blue color. That means we know that one, whenever the solution color is blue color turns, That means chromium oxidization is over. In this one, whenever the color solution turned into light pink, oxidization of manganate ion also over. Okay, like this, in the titrations, we can use this type of the redox reaction. Okay, so it is our total stoichiometry. Okay, so in the stoichiometry, what we discussed here, main important oxidation number is over. Second one here, we completed that one, redox reactions. Okay, and balancing also completed. Okay, and also we are completed about the mole. Okay, the mole concept, and also we are completed molecular formula, empirical formula, what is the relationship between those, and also we are completed the concentration terminologies. So concentration terminologies is nothing but mole fraction, okay, and molarity and normality and molality. Okay, and also we are completed mass percentage. So it is the information about the stoichiometry.